It's Friday, February 6, 2015. Hello, I'm Veronique Masterson. Here's what you need to know about what's happening at the University of Texas at El Paso. UTEP researchers are learning that pharmaceuticals and personal care products like toothpaste and coffee can affect aquatic life and not in a good way. In analyzing water samples, UTEP biologist Dr. Elizabeth Walsh and student researchers found the presence of multiple pollutants, including a pain reliever, antidepressant, and an antibacterial. The team also collected microscopic zooplankton found in the Rio Grande and other freshwater sites, and over the course of several years applied moderate to high doses of caffeine, acetaminophen, and triclosan. The aquatic organisms showed a decrease in population growth rate, and some produced morphological deformities. The results raised concerns about potential effects on the food cycle. Walsh is now working with chemist Dr. Wen Yi Li to study the concentrations of these compounds in the Rio Grande. The highest court of criminal appeals in the state of Texas made its first ever visit to El Paso and UTEP to hear arguments in two cases. Students and faculty with UTEP's Patricia and Paul Yetter Law School Preparation Institute had the unique opportunity to watch. The court usually sits in Austin and makes several visits to other cities each year, mostly to courtrooms at major law schools. More than 100 guests celebrated longtime political science professor Dr. Tony Kruczewski as he retired after 50 years of teaching, 46 of which were spent here at UTEP. He was born in Poland and worked as a spy for the Polish resistance against the Nazis by his teens. After his service with the resistance movement, Kruczewski fought for the Warsaw Uprising in 1944, then the Polish Army in 1945. In 1952, he immigrated to Chicago with $51 in his pocket. Kruczewski arrived in El Paso in 1968 and witnessed the discrimination Mexican Americans faced, which fueled his determination to teach his students the importance of standing up, being counted, and fighting for democratic rights. An estimated 15,000 students' lives were touched by Dr. Kruczewski.
And I would like to thank UTEP for giving me a chance to participate in transforming U.S. university programs and fighting for tolerance and equal opportunity for future generation and offering equal opportunity for U.S. minorities.
For more information about these and other stories, check out utepnews.com. I'm Veronique Masterson. We'll see you next Friday. Go Miners!